Welcome to this, what is it, part three of this monitor lizard. And I've been, in the last 5 minutes, I've been looking at what I've got to do. And I notice this branch is very blue where it hits the light, but it's got a brown tinge in the shadow. So I'm just going to use the airbrush to give it a brown tinge. Some water in there and burn tumbler, I think, which is this one. I'm just going to put this in neat. I'm not going to worry about masking the leg, because that's going to get completely covered later anyway. There's a little patch of light here, so I'll avoid that bit and go straight over there, because that's pretty brown anyway. A bit more than that. A little bit in the shadows up here as well. A few spots here and there. Go quite dark here, because I will pick out the texture in a lighter colour. Because this bark has a huge amount of texture in it. I think I'll put a bead in that edge. That'll do. Must clean the airbrush out immediately. It's disastrous if you let paint dry inside it. Right. Now on with the texture of this branch. I'm going to need a lighter version of this blue I've got here. Do I remember what I used last time? Nope, never mind. Right. Let's try a bit of indigo. With the gouache white. That's got the right sort of blue-grey look. Could be too dark. It's more of that large white in there. Now what I've got here is a very old beaten up brush. So I want the bristles to be splayed, so yeah, that's too dark, but I can actually use that because I do need darker splodges as well. So while I've got this colour, I'll add it. I didn't want to do that, go across that edge, but never mind. I'm going to end up going over these black lines, but never mind, I can re-establish them. Which I'm probably going to need to do several times anyway. I don't know whether you're noticing how much darker the paint dries. Since I put the paint on, you see a little spot of light, and then a second later it's gone dark. That is the biggest drawback with watercolours. Now before I put the lighter splodges in, I think closer to the shadow it's got brown splodges. So let's try that Mars brown again. See what that looks like. Too strong, so it is too strong, but there are some bits like that. So while I've got the colour,
a bit of white to lighten it. Just a touch, see how that looks. Get this brush more splayed out. You'll be amazed at how many colours you can find in something like a tree bark, especially when you add to that the light. To get rid of nearly all the paint now, do a kind of dry brush, still too much. This brush is desperately trying to go back to a proper shape.
I keep bashing it.
Don't do this to your lovely new brushes. Won't be surprised if this one's 20 years old. I'll get some little lines in it as well. Not sure if that's working, never mind. Now some of that brown has got quite a bit of red, so I think I'll use English red, which is the fifth one along. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So don't want it too red. Mix that with the Mars brown. Because there's a patch here that's very red. Will that dry dark? That's just about right. And over there it's almost purple. Haven't seen that before. Actually, some of this colour can work in there as well. Streaky lines in. If you've got a colour mixed and you see it can be used somewhere else, just put it in while you've still got it. Let's take some of that blue and add a little bit of violet, just a little bit. Ooh, that's powerful. That's rather a lot. So go back to the indigo. A bit more of the quite the right colour yet. Too blue. That could be it. I'll just do it dry brush. So get rid of nearly all the paint. It's not light enough, so a bit of the white. Give it some slightly opaque properties. And it's not red enough. Try that. Yeah, that's about it. Just a little hint of it. A little lighter version of it. Just to go around the edge. So it's catching the light. Go back to the dry brush and fade it out a bit. Now, before I leave that, is that colour anywhere else? Maybe ever so slightly over here. That should be darker actually. Do that at a later date with the airbrush. Which I'm seeing more and more of this colour all over. Need a bit more white because there's a few tiny little highlights in there in this colour. Should probably use a different brush, but got this in my hand now. And now I can do what I was going to do in the first place, the lighter version of that one, which is over here. So have I got it light enough this time? I think so. Is that a bit too much? Sorry, so fade it out. go back to the brown version, although it's practically got some, make some more. Give my tiny bit of white for opacity purposes. There's some light catches down here. Now this bit here is more yellow than brown, well brown and yellow rather, so take some of that colour and a bit of cadmium yellow medium. Might not have enough white on that, let's see what it looks like. Okay, from there. I'm going to pinch some of that white without touching the purple. This is just some highlights up here. It's a bit too much, but I'll spread it out. Deep gouges in there. To give these highlights a reason to exist. On this bit as well. Very light version of that. I just want to There's some edges here that the light is catching. These might get toned down later with the airbrush. At the moment, I'm happy for them to be quite bold. I want a blue version of that for the highlights in this area. Some of these I think I'll just fade out a little. Just using clear water here. And as the white is gouache, it does get reactivated when you wet it. A useful feature and a curse at the same time. Sometimes you don't want it to do that.
Right, I think that's enough on the bark. I might come back to it after the lizard. So, how are we going to tackle this lizard with all these thousands of scales? I think I'm going to mix up the mid-tone of the scales with the blue ones. It's not a million miles away from this one. Test this out. This is a test at the moment. Oh, I'm going to need glasses for this. This is more or less just a first pass to give me an indication of where the scales are. Now I'm not attempting to copy the amount and position of the scales accurately. Just give it the flavour. I've got to try and, there's a lot along here, they're not quite as at an angle, quite straight along here. It's got a patch up here. As I say, this is not by a long way going to be the final look. I just want an indication where they are, because I will have to go around every one of these with a dark colour and then go around it with a highlight. Yeah. Oh, I didn't want that white. Anyway. There's a little patch of blue ones here. And one here. Once I'm a bit more confident what I'm doing, I'll speed up. I'm not caring about shadows either, because some of these scales are obviously in shadow and they'll be darker, but I can maybe do that with the airbrush later. Scales are a lot smaller on his head.
This is what's so I like about painting, doing detail like this. It's hard to think of anything else. It's nice and relaxing. It's not going into circles now because I haven't got enough paint. So indigo. A bit of white. Is that enough? That'll do. Oh, hello, Julie. Keep forgetting to look in the chat. It's definitely darker. More white. Ah, oh, Teresa, you're here. Good to see you. Or see the typing, that is. I'm visiting you from the future. Because apparently this live stream is about 15 seconds behind. More or less back to the colour I had. Maybe a fraction darker, but never mind. Just the first pass. How are we doing for time? 15 minutes to go. Hopefully I can establish these blue ones. The real pain is going to be this arm, because it's just a big mishmash of blue and yellow scales. Looking very random. Scales do a weird thing here. They go down there and they kind of divide and go off around here. So we get a new line coming out of nothing. Several new lines. Teresa, what type of lizard is it? It's a Filipino monitor lizard. And I
took the reference photo at London Zoo. And I must admit, I bumped up the colours a bit. He is yellow and blue, but I made the blue more blue and the yellow more yellow. Now quite these patches do have the odd yellow one in the middle. I've decided to ignore that for the moment and can go over it. The yellow scales that are in the middle of this blue, I can just put them in over the top later with the addition of the gouache white, which makes it opaque. You couldn't do this if you're just using pure watercolours. I used to be a purist and just do watercolours, but the amount of planning you need to do, because you can't put light over dark, I got fed up with that, so I thought, sod it, I'll add gouache. Yeah, through the artistic license. Yep. All that matters is the end result. No one cares how you got there when they're looking at the finished painting. Which is why I'm not averse to adding the final details with a bit of coloured pencil. I'm not totally ruling it out doing it here. Do I really need to do that one? My painting's creeping outwards and downwards, and a lot of this is going to be cropped. Might just catch the edge of that, so I will do some here. Few blue ones around here. Because what also happens with these scales on a lot of the yellow ones, all around the head and a lot around here and all over there, the yellow scales are on a yellow background. But in some places, the yellow scales are on a blue background, especially this part of the arm leg.
There are some definite
blue ones up here. And this little patch has gone small. The scales are a lot smaller around this. I'm guessing it's because that's where there's a big crease. And nature has given him
smaller scales there,
so it's got flexibility. That's my guess. Oh, I'm so undecided about this leg. Maybe you can see. No, you can't. This is my problem. I think I'll do the whole leg as though it's blue, and then overlay the where it goes yellow. Follow the roundness of the leg.
Yeah, yes, Julie,
nature is amazing. Because on this part of the arm, keep calling it an arm, it's just another leg, the scales are big again, because there it doesn't bend. But come to the elbow, they've all gone small again. So it's definitely something to do with flexibility.
And Teresa, I'm using what are they called? St. Peter's watercolours. The actual, they're Russian, so the actual name is that, if you could read that. And then I've just added this designer gouache, Caran d'Ache. I'm getting to the close to the point where scales are getting smaller again. Not a huge amount in it, they're not a fraction the size of the bigger ones. Nearly there. Right, there we have it. Oh, about that. Dead on the hour. And I think that's a perfect spot to finish. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you next Wednesday. Goodbye, everybody.